Hey, what's up, everybody? It is TJ from Southern Satellite back again with another Behind the Mix with the one and only Greg White, SG Studios in Fort Worth, Texas. Check out his stuff. This is the first time I've got to work with Greg. Greg's been a friend of mine for, 15 years probably. And I don't know why it took us so long to get together, but we finally got together on this. I highly recommend him. I'm not just saying that because he pays me lots of money to say that. If only.
What are we talking about now?
Today we are diving into Bigger Better Than You. This song, I don't know if we worked on a song longer than this one. We started with drums and bass guitars. I mean, we went everywhere with this song.
In pre-production, yeah. We cut MIDI tracks trying to figure out which way to go. And the reason it's so hard is because you wrote a really weird rhythmic song.
I am guilty of that from time to time. This is seven. It's in seven, but it's a 4-3 instead of a 3-4. Is that right?
Yes.
Yeah. So normally in a seven time signature, it'd be 1-2-3, 1-2-3-4. We're going 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3, 1-2-3. So it kind of turned everything on its head.
So measure a four, measure a three to make seven.
Right. This is one of my favorite guitar songs that I've ever written. And so I think we tried to focus on the acoustic first and then build around it. But anyways, in the end, we ended up with some pigs, and there were some cows in here, and we got some chains. I think I threw an outboard motor in one part of it. I'm not sure, but let's let them hear a little bit of it, and then we'll, ow. It's like my back just got cramped from the stress of this song. Anyways, we'll dive into it for a quick second, then we'll start breaking it down. Needy guitar.
Tell who you're talking to. This dog will haunt
you. All right, so there's a lot going on. Where do we start? Let's see.
I think we need to start with, you wrote almost, it's not classical style, but you wrote a piece on the guitar. A lot of your guitar parts are that way. They're very specific. You think about every section and really specifically write it out. I mean, it's a...
We finished with what, five mics?
Yeah, I think I recorded seven.
We had seven acoustic mics.
This is just an acoustic song, but it doesn't really translate like that. No. There's no bass in this
song. I mean, yeah, literally it's acoustic and some strings and foot stomps and chains. But I remember when we first laid it all out, all these yellow tracks, we had massive amounts, and luckily he was able to dump them down to, we ended up with five.
Yeah,
I believe we DI'd this originally.
Yeah, there's a DI here.
Oh, okay.
Well, I ended up using it for the beef, you know, just to add that extra oomph. That's all the DI's given us.
Okay.
Just the oomph. Yeah. So I had more room mics that I ended up not using in the mix.
Essentially, I believe we just put down the guitar track with dry vocals, and then we started building around it. And I believe it was one whole day for probably 12, 13 hours. It was just me and Greg, and we were trying to figure out where this song wanted to go, because it was almost to the point where we were scared it wasn't even going to make the record.
Yeah. The chain idea.
That's right. We were out of ideas, and I said something like, let's just drop a chain. And you were like, I've always wanted to do that. And so we were like, okay, screw it.
Always talked about doing it, never did it.
So we went to the bus, and we have chains, if we ever get stuck in mud, which I hope never happens. And we found, we went searching through the studio, and we found like
A metal sawhorse.
And I can cut to the video right now.
Shoot. One, shoot, three.
Thank you. So as you see, so we have this metal sawhorse and this chain, and he just hit the button, and I just started doing whatever, and it ended up being this awesome little chain thing that we kind of came up with. So from there, we're like, okay, well this is kind of grooving. And I believe we had the foot stomps. And so I had, I believe we used guitar cases. I had so many guitars in the studio at the time. And I think it was me and Hash and somebody else. It might have been Kanoi. Yes,
your bus driver.
Our bus driver. And we got in there and we just started literally stomping on the cases on the floor. And we had room mics pick it up. And we got that.
Yeah, I like that you can feel the foot lift up. And then you put the chains in with it. And it's this back and forth thing.
Yeah, that kind of heave-ho kind of thing that it turned into.
It really is a masterpiece. I mean, the way you crafted this song is much like a classical piece. And then has all this, it goes around the world, and then it comes into the first verse. You can't break this man
into. Well, we did fail if we didn't mention Milo. So Milo, we had all this built out, and then Milo came in, and we said, hey, since you can play banjo and mandolin and guitar and tuba, do you mind playing some cello too? And he was like, yeah, totally. That's so
whole string section.
Yeah, so he does a cello part, and then he's like, okay, that's cool. I'm going to do a second cello part. And then he does a viola part. So we end up with this three-part beautiful string section that Milo Deering did, and it kind of comes in and out of the record as well. We were going, it was a Steve Earle song that we listened to in pre-production. It was about the soldier.
I can't remember the name of the song, but it has a string section only on the right side that's so awesome that I usually turn the left side off.
Beautiful. I love it. So cool. When I say the word bigger, better than you,
Oh, yeah. We
had Medulla. He does this real raspy, bigger, better than you thing. And it's just a little texture that you wouldn't really notice in the whole song. But if you're listening for it, you can hear it. And
You'll notice it now.
It just kind of fills in that little spot.
I'm bigger, better than you.
Yeah. Now, that's all it is.
Okay.
But when you put it all together in context,
bigger, better than you.
It just adds this little.
Careful now we.
Yeah, it's really cool. It gives it a really, once again, not creepy vibe, but a dark vibe.
I'm bigger, better than you.
I'm doing this a solo, kind of solo thing on the acoustic, and then he comes over the top with the viola, and it turns into this swirl of emotion with the chains and everything. So I'm gonna hear that. Quick. So I did something. It was just in a take. We were cutting vocals. Sometimes you just experiment. You usually delete all that stuff. But I started doing this Lindsey Buckingham thing from Big House, I think is the song. And he just said, ooh, ah, ooh, ah. And so I started doing the ooh, ah. And
we had Jared.
And then Greg was like, that's really cool. Let's keep it. And so, yeah, then we had Jared come in and do it with me. So we do these ooh ahs over that viola section as well.
You solo the strings in that section, in that, because it's really cool together.
And that was just one of those. You know, that's what I love about being in the studio and creating is just that was never intended. I was goofing off. And I was like, ooh, ah, and it turned into being on the record. This was really a fun song after we finally got it going where it wanted to go.
It's one of my favorite productions on the record. It took so long to get there, and then figuring out the chains idea, and then the groove in the verses that have that 7/8 thing or the 4/3, the beat turns around in it. It gives a really cool vibe.
The lift to the end. I think we have the drum coming in too. Milo.
Rattle this cage and I'm gonna break. You don't know just what's at stake. Come on, boy, get out of my face. I'm bigger, better than you.
Yeah. What a fun song. It was. We fought that song. We fought it hard. And
that's the longest I've ever worked on a song. One song. I mean, we spent just probably 8 hours in pre-production alone trying to figure out how to...
And then we erased it after pre-production, and then we started back over again.
Yeah.
But me and Greg are both so hard-headed individuals that we refused to give up on it. And I think that we really did the song justice. It's such a unique song. I don't know of anything else that's out there kind of like that.
There's no references for me when I was mixing it, or it's just on our own path.
Yeah, it's a fun one. So anyways, Bigger, Better Than You, I hope you enjoy. Here we go.
Tell who you're talking to. This dog will hunt and come on blue. You can't break this man in two. I'm bigger, better than you. Be careful now when you try to speak. I'll lock a boy and cut you deep. I'll break you down to a bended knee. I'm bigger, better than you. I'm too proud to be pushed around. Stubborn, born way too loud. Not gonna let you run me down. I'm bigger, better than you. I've seen your smile, I've seen your ways. Writing lines that you can't pay. Come on, boy, get out of my face. Bigger, better than you. No, I don't lie, I tell the truth. Want the fire, it's gonna rain on you. Know who's told you gotta hold on to. I'm bigger, better than you. But I'll play nice if you walk away. You rattle this cage and I'm gonna break. You don't know just what's at stake. I'm bigger, better than you. I'm too proud to be pushed around. Up and born and way too loud. Not gonna let you run me down. I'm bigger, better than you. I've seen your smile, I've seen your ways. Writing lies that you can't pay. Come on, boy, get out of my face. Bigger, better than you.
So there you have it, Bigger, Better Than You, from the new record, 12 Years in the Valley by Southern Satellite. I hope you enjoyed it. Keep up to date. We're going to continue to keep this little series going because of the great positive feedback that we've gotten from it. So thank you so much for the comments and engaging and being a part of it. I'm just really excited to show you what happens kind of behind the scenes instead of just like, hey, here's a new record. So I really appreciate y'all watching and being a part of. So anyways, until next time, say bye, Greg.
Bye.